Okay, well, the kids, you know, they're home from school and looking for things to do, but it also means they have more time on their hands to swallow items around the house they should be even putting near their mouth. Gastroenterologist Dr. Amina Nasir with Mercy Children's Hospital is here with a warning for parents this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
So you have kind of seen an uptick with kids coming in and swallowed coins is the biggest one?
Correct, correct. I think the seasonality is more incidental. We see them all through the year. Sometimes they come in runs of threes and fives.
Okay.
So coins being the most common, and their problems are more sitting in the wrong place and staying there too long. Mm-hmm. 60% of coins are going to pass. So parents don't need to worry about a non-choking, non-troubled child. If they watch a penny being swallowed, it's going to probably pass. But if it's anything different, it's a quarter, it's sitting up here, the child's drooling, in any kind of trouble from vomiting, change in behavior, seek help.
Yeah, so is it mostly will pass to the stomach, it doesn't get stuck in the esophagus?
Size, it's all dependent on the size. Quarters usually like to sit in three places in the food pipe, right where the clavicles jut in, then where the heart vessels go and push on the esophagus, and the third place being the sphincter. So that's where these quarters and bigger objects get caught.
Okay, what toys should parents be aware of in terms of age-appropriate toys?
Perfect. So toys can cause trouble with two problems. One, loose objects on them.
Okay.
Three, these little dollies that have accessories. Mm-hmm. So age-appropriate accessories on toys. And then barrettes on babies. 7-month-olds and 8-month-olds with barrettes in their head.
Mm-hmm.
They pluck them out and they like to eat them, which then like to get stuck right in here somewhere.
Yeah, what about when it comes to storing chemicals?
Oh, that is one of those dangerous ingestions. So summertime or throughout the year, parents will store cleaners and chemicals in their leftover coffee cups from, we're not going to take names, from other stores, you know, from coffee stores.
Sure.
And that becomes very enticing to a child.
Oh my goodness,
so that's probably not a good idea. So child-proofing your house involves chemicals, involves choking hazards, and involves those sockets and all.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes we may not notice it right away. What are some of the symptoms that your child may have swallowed something?
Great question. So it depends on what they swallowed. If you witnessed a penny, they may have nothing. Otherwise, they may be drooling. Most common is drooling.
Okay.
Second, we can see vomiting. Third, we've seen kids who have cough. They're drooling, but they're coughing with batteries. We've seen batteries that can erode into from the food pipe into the breathing pipe.
Mm.
And, you know, the last and most important, your mama feeling. If you feel like your child's not acting right, it's time to go seek help.
That mother's intuition sometimes.
Yes.
You know, another thing I was reading is fidget spinners, and it seems like they're in all kids' hands today, but they're also choking hazards because the little parts, as I've seen with my kids, come out.
Come apart, yes,
yeah.
Correct. So 2012, we had the big American Academy of Pediatrics push on taking magnets out of retailers.
Those like button magnets?
Yes. Those Bucky magnets. Now the new thing is these fidget spinners. We're trying to get these fidget spinners off the shelf also. Same thing. They have those little bearings in them. They have those loose parts that love to get stuck in the food pipe.
What should you do when you're looking for a toy? Just look at the age on there, and if it doesn't have the age,
then use your mama intuition.
Yeah,
and then
okay.
Again, make sure they're not extra parts, especially under 3-year-old. Those under 3-year-olds are sneaky characters. They can open up anything. And then the other thing that turns into a hazard is the remote control or gadgets in our house.
Oh.
You know, they have buttons and button batteries in them. So make sure you screw on those button batteries, even if you need to put a little bit of duct tape to avoid those sneaky little artists that we have.
All right. Dr. Nasir, thank you so much.
We appreciate
your time this morning. Pediatric GI with Mercy Children's Hospital. For more information on choking hazards, just head to the STL Moms tab. They're sneaky.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. All right, thank you. Bicycle.